Hello friends, in this video I am going to talk about the UVR and create its interpretation. So now we will see the real life scenario, real case, and how you will interpret the UVR and create in reserve. So normal level of UVR is around 15 to 50 milligram per deciliter, and for creatinine, male is 0.6 to 1.3, female is 0.5 to 1.2. In male, normally the creatinine upper reference is high because of the muscle mass. So if you see this report, urea 17, creatinine 0.5, this is a normal report for the urea and creatinine. So patient's kidney function is normal. Again, urea 27, create 1.1, so that is again a normal report. This is normal, normal renal function test, right? Now you see here, urea 77 and create 2.7. So when urea increase, urea level is normally around 30, creatinine level is 1. This is the ratio normal. So whenever there is an acute kidney injury or renal damage, this urea and creatinine both will be increased. As you know, urea and creatinine both are excreted via the kidney. Okay, they are excreted into the urine via the kidney, and when kidney is not functioning, then this substance will not be excreted, urea and creatinine, and their level in the blood is increased. So increased level of urea and creatinine, that is suggestive of renal damage. So it can be acute renal failure, it can be chronic renal failure, it can be renal cell carcinoma, or it may be the glomerulonephritis or pyelonephritis. All are the cause of increased urea and creatinine level. So here urea is 89 and creatinine is normal. So urea high but creatinine normal. So what could be this condition? So here we know urea is increased in pre-renal, renal and post-renal. So when the pre-renal cause, it may be due to the dehydration, increased urea, or heart failure, or GI hemorrhage because of increased bleeding tendency. So from RBC, globin chain is separated, amino acid level will increase, and so urea level will be increased. Suppose patient has the level of 40 milligram per deciliter is 100 ml. If dehydration, if volume is decreased, suppose from 40 milligram, the volume is decreased to 50 ml. So relatively, the concentration will be increased. So in dehydration also, urea level is increased. The heart failure, right, GI hemorrhage, or all catalytical condition like sepsis, right, sepsis, trauma, okay, or patient taking corticosteroid, in all this condition, the urea level is increased, but creatinine level is normal. Okay, so this report, urea 138, creatinine 14.7. So most likely the high creatinine level is because of the chronic renal failure, or it may be due to the acute renal failure. So kidney damage. Okay, so kidney damage lead to the both urea and creatinine level high. Now you can see this report. Urea is lower than the normal. Most of the condition when urea is increased due to the pre-renal, renal or post-renal, but here urea is decreased. Also creatinine is slight normal. Okay, as we know, urea decrease and creatinine normal. This may be due to the severe liver damage. As we know, urea is synthesized only in liver. Okay, because this arginase enzyme is present only in liver. So whenever there is a severe liver damage, you can see here bilirubin is increased. So it is maybe due to the severe liver injury. So severe liver injury lead to the hepatocyte cellular damage, and the cells that produce the urea, they will not form the urea. Okay, so urea level will be decreased. Then here you can see urea is about to normal, but creatinine is high. So urea normal and creatinine high. So creatinine, as we know, it also increases in muscular injury. So muscle damage Okay, early muscle damage, the creatinine level will be increased, like you can muscular dystrophy or rhabdomyolysis. So they are very rare, but you should remember, base doctor should remember that creatinine level might be increased in case of muscle damage. Here, this might be the case of dialysis. After the dialysis, urea is removed, so urea returns normal, creatinine returns to the normal, it takes a while. So after dialysis, urea level will be normal, but creatinine still remains high. Right. Here, urea 156, creatinine 1.7. So it may be due to the pre-renal course, like dehydration, diarrhea, vomiting, dehydration, congestive cardiac failure, or sepsis, GI hemorrhage. So all these conditions lead to the increased urea, but creatinine just little bit higher. Or it may be due to the high bilirubin that interfere in creatinine estimation. Right? Again, this report, urea 95, create 1.4, it may be due to the pre-renal causes, as I mentioned earlier, or interference of high bilirubin level. Here, urea 1.5, create 1.6, bili normal, that means it is a pre-renal causes. Then urea 154, create 1.6, again pre-renal. Then urea decrease, creatinine slight normal, so severe liver damage. Okay, where liver cell, hepatocellular cell cannot produce the urea. Again, urea normal, slightly little bit higher than the normal or high creatinine. So just before dialysis, in case of chronic renal failure, after the dialysis, you will find this type of result. Then urea around just little bit high and creatinine is very high. As we know, ratio is around 30:1, urea to creatinine. But here creatinine is more. So just after the dialysis, you will find this type of picture. Okay, so this is all about the estimation and interpretation of urea and creatinine. I hope you find this video very helpful. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share my video, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get notification for my future video also. Thank you friends for watching. Bye.